Respected guest of the day, Dr. Vignesh Swarnamohan, teachers and my dear friends, a warm good afternoon to all of you. It is a pleasure to have you here for the NDLI orientation at Bhavans Vidya Mandir, Erur. To make available to the learners community learning resources through a single window reads the welcome page of NDLI or National Digital Library of India. With the aim of making the most of digital resources, NDLI is definitely an asset for all students and educators. And today, we have gathered for an orientation to this platform by Dr. Vignesh Swarnamohan. May I invite our very own Purnima Miss to deliver the address of welcome.
Thank you, Maithili. Namaste. Good afternoon to everyone present here. Respected Principal, Srimati Parvati E. Respected Vice Principal, Srimati Ramya Das. Esteemed Speaker of the Day, Dr. Vignesh Swarnamohan. Respected teachers and my dear students, as I flip through the pages of my lovely childhood memories about my school, the image that first comes to my mind is that of the heaven of all book lovers. Yes, the library, the silent temple of boundless knowledge. Discussing about the new arrivals, listening to the reviews about different books from the librarian, helping her to set the books in order, etc. were some of the most interesting pastimes of those days. 2020, even though it was the most challenging year that humans have ever faced, it was also the year which brought about huge differences in the way we do things. This event itself proves as an example for this. During the initial days of lockdown, people started sharing audiobooks and e-books, which means even those challenging days did not keep us away from books. They are always our best companions. Here the role of NDLI becomes more important. National Digital Library of India is a virtual repository of learning resources sponsored and mentored by Ministry of Education, Government of India, through its national mission on education through information and technology. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to the NDLI orientation session. First, I would like to extend a warm welcome to the esteemed speaker of the day, Dr. Vignesh Swarnamohan, Chief Strategic and Outreach Officer, National Digital Library of India, IIT Kharagpur, on behalf of everyone present here. Welcome, sir. I feel extremely honored to welcome our Principal Srimati Parvati E and our Vice Principal Srimati Ramya Das, who always extend their unfailing support and guidance for the growth of our institution. I extend a hearty welcome to you, ma'am. Last but not the least, I would like to take this opportunity to welcome the teachers and students of the NDLI club who are eagerly waiting to know more about NDLI. Hope you have an enriching session ahead. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. The past few months have been different, and while attending online classes, there were a number of things that we students greatly missed about the school campus. One among them is undoubtedly the school library. Whether it is to learn something new, to satisfy our own curiosity, or to simply indulge in the joy that a good story brings, it is a library and its plethora of books that we turn to. Here we have a small video presentation on the Book Lover's Paradise, the BVA Meerut Library.
Joy wanted so many things this year. To travel around the world, to visit the wonderland, meet the fairies and elves, cruise through the skies, see the planets and what not. So his parents took him to a library, and Joy was never joyless ever. Sounds too simple, right? But the power of a book and the magnetism a library has for a book lover cannot be undermined.
I love spending time to read books sitting in my school library. It is so quiet that one would really enjoy reading and learn peacefully, learn about the world, the people and our environment. Informations could be gathered from a library, and our school library is a great collection of books. I love my library very much.
Established in 1997, the Library of Bhavans Vidyamandir Erur has embraced generations of learners in its vast garden. Never to return a book lover empty-handed, the library has been nurtured and sustained under able librarians over the years. With technology making its mark in every field, our school library has also been upgraded to meet the expectations of 21st century learner. Today, our library has added to its welcoming ambience with a facelift, keeping in mind the present aesthetic appreciation everywhere. The library has a reading room with a sitting capacity of 40 students. Students are encouraged to utilize the provisions of the library in their free time, and the reading room caters to this. Well equipped in fiction and non-fiction, the library also has special collections in self-help, biographies, references and Bhavans publications. We are constantly upgrading our collection and soon will incorporate books in subjects that are emerging trends such as artificial intelligence, robotics and other subjects relevant to the school's curriculum. We also subscribe to prominent newspaper and magazines, including teachers' professional development titles such as Mentor, Teacher Plus, etc. Magazine and newspaper subscriptions include Malayalam, Hindi and English subscriptions, as well as the Sanskrit newspaper Sudharma. Monthly quizzes are held on various topics such as a series of books, authors, award winners in literature, etc., for which a quiz box is set up in the circulation table and all students are welcome to drop in their responses. Publishing companies and prominent book vendors hold book fairs biannually in the school, which gives the students and staff a chance to pick up books of their choice. June 19, Reading Day. Commemorating the death anniversary of P.N. Narayana Panikkar, the father of library movement in Kerala, Mr. Murli Tumarakudi, author and operations manager at the Crisis Management Branch of United Nations Environment Programme, addressed the students on reading and its importance today.
എരുവൂരിലെ ഭവൻസ് വിദ്യാമന്ദിറിലെ കുട്ടികളോട് ഈ വായനാ ദിനത്തിൽ സംസാരിക്കാൻ അവസരം കിട്ടിയതിൽ എനിക്കേറെ സന്തോഷമുണ്ട്.
Students performed various reading related events such as storytelling, recitation, role play, etc. The programs included storytelling session in Sanskrit by the students of the primary wing.
Hari Mitrani ekam vane ekah tadagah asit tatra ekah kachapah ekah mushakah ekah harinah cha ekah kakah nivasanti sma.
Talk on favorite books by students and teachers, Hindi and English poetry recital, etc. Reading week was celebrated in November from 16th to 21st. Storyteller Rasika Raman enticed the tiny tots of grade 1 and 2 with a wonderful storytelling session. Grade 1 to 5 had talent show in which they performed role play, puppet show, storytelling, etc. Grade 8 and 9 had an inter-house literary quiz competition. NDLI Club was set up in August 2020 with 51 members, including both staff and students. Orientations have been given in classes from 6 to 12 and all the faculty departments regarding the use of this platform. All students and staff of the school have been registered with NDLI. We are also institutional member. This year, with the school going online, online library classes are being delivered to the students of 6th and 7th, where authors and their works get discussed. We have a book reading session in which we collectively read a book and discuss the characters, author, etc. Students also read and submit book reviews every month to their Google classrooms. Funtainment in the form of Kahoot, an online quizzing platform, keeps the students engaged and enriched. BVM Erur has added a virtual library in its school website, which aims to act as an access point to the vast collection of reading material available in the open access platforms. Author of the month scrolls across our website, introducing an author whose birthday falls during the current month. Here, a short biography of the author, including his or her famous works, along with pointers, are provided. This pandemic has made a lot of changes in the world. Books seem to be the only prop we can hang on to. A library holds within it a treasure, an escape from reality for some, or a pathway to the actual world for others. In all scenarios, BVM Erur Library awaits the return of its bookworms and dreamers with hope and many more fun-filled activities.
A library is a place where I can be myself and explore my world. This is a place where we frame questions and find answer to it. Books enrich our imagination without any compromise. We have a wonderful library in our school, Bhavans Vidya Mandir Erur. It has an amazing collection of books which gives me a chance to read so many best and favorite books. That's the reason why library is my favorite place in the school.
Of course, no event is complete without a few words from my dear principal. I'd like to invite Parvati ma'am to speak to us on this occasion.
Thank you, Maithili. Namaste and a warm good evening to one and all present here. When you are in trouble, head to the library. Either you have a solution or simply you have something to read as the world crashes down around you. In this pandemic situation, when we are imprisoned within the four walls, heading to a library is not an easy task, I know. This is where NDLI comes to our rescue. NDLI, as you all know, it's a virtual world full of books and resources in digitalized formats where a person can access any resource at the click of a button. It's easy to use. Any resource can be accessed here with a single search option. Now, this initiative by the Ministry of Human Resource Development and hosted by IIT Kharagpur is indeed a milestone in the field of education in India. With NDLI in place, education has become more dramatic, I should say. I'm extremely happy that all our students have enrolled with the NDLI and our club members periodically conduct various activities, involve themselves in discussions and deliberations. And I'm sure we'll be able to make use of one of the best available resources in the country to its fullest. I take this opportunity to thank Dr. Vignesh Swarnamohan for being here to guide our children and the faculties on the effective use of the resources of NDLI. Thank you so much, sir. And I make use of this opportunity to congratulate the coordinating teacher, Ms. Priya Don Thomas, for having taken the lead in the effective implementation of NDLI in our school. Thank you, Priya, and thank you all teachers, all the faculty members, and all the students who have joined on this platform today. Thank you, and my greetings to each one of you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now it is the time that we have all been waiting for. To familiarize us with the NDLI portal, we have with us the Chief Strategic and Outreach Officer, National Digital Library of India, Dr. Vignesh Swarnamohan. Over to you, sir.
Thank you so much, Mithili. I hope my audio is clear.
Yes, sir.
Is it fine? Okay, thank you. Respected principal, Ms. Parvati Yi, the librarian, Ms. Priya Dashini, thank you so much for inviting us for this webinar. You are, I think, one of the first NDLA clubs from the Bhavan School. I think your club was launched on the 15th of August last year. So it's been almost about 3 months. You are one of those early starters in the group of schools. So I congratulate each one of you for starting this club. And special thanks to Ms. Priyadarshini for anchoring it. So, and thank you for being on a Friday afternoon. I think most of you, including myself, we have already started sitting in the weekend mode. But still, you all have this online classes. So do I. So I have to take classes on the weekend. So it's like sitting at home, enjoying your holiday, and also doing your homework. So it's like a blessing in a disguise. So unlike other normal days where we used to spend time, especially the weekends, with a lot of fun-filled and joyful activities, we used to play, we used to enjoy, we used to read. But now the situation is different. So having said this, this pandemic, the COVID-19 pandemic, which nobody could predict in the last few years, except a movie which was made a few years back about a pandemic which could hit the world. But how do you think that imagination could have come into the minds of the so-called director or the script writer? In my view, in my personal view, reading is something that opens up the mind, right? So when you are restricting yourself only to the textbooks, especially the curriculum books which have been prescribed, and you prepare only through the books, I think that we are actually killing the creativity. So the creativity has to come, or might come, especially when you read beyond your textbooks, when you read a lot of fictions, where you read fantasy novels and a lot of interesting stories. These opens up the minds of the young children, right? So during our times, so the best storyteller every home could have is the grandmother, right? I remember my grandmother, while we were kids, she used to keep all the grandchildren around her, and she used to tell a lot of stories which are very sometimes funny, sometimes very ethical, moral values. And she used to feed us dinner, and then she used to tell the stories. So, but today's the situation is slightly different. I think many of the families have become very nuclear. So that opportunity has been almost missing with many of the children. But we were one of those blessed children who had a great time listening to the stories of our from our grandparents. So now this pandemic. So if you look at the pandemic, the situation, nobody was prepared, including the teachers. I interacted with a lot of teachers, and many of them were finding it exciting and challenging, because this is the first time that they are exploring something that we never thought we will do, because conducting an online class has never been so thought of, right? Except very few institutions which was practicing online classes once in a while, but today the situation has changed. So the first challenge that many of the faculty members and the students faced was, where is the resources which can be used for conducting online classes? And believe it or not, during this pandemic, at least 1 crore people used the National Digital Library of India. Now let's see what type of content that is available at the NDLI, right? So I will just quickly run through this presentation. So is the presentation visible?
Yes,
yes, sir.
Thank you. I will quickly turn off my video. Okay, so in today's session, we are going to look at why NDLI was created, what kind of content we have, how do we use it, what is the difference between Google and NDLI, and how to operate an NDLI club. Since you have already started the NDLI club, I will just touch upon very few aspects of the NDLI club. So now, I will tell you why NDLI was created. So pandemic is a recent phenomena which happened, especially the COVID-19 pandemic, which happened very recently. But the National Digital Library of India was conceived way back in 2014 and 15. It came into existence on 19th June 2016. It was launched as a pilot project to understand whether digital knowledge resources can be actually used to take the quality knowledge resources to every Indian citizen. So the major challenge that many of the institutions were facing is the financial challenges, because when you have a physical library and if you have to procure resources, it's going to cost a lot of money, right? And also it would require a lot of physical spaces to stack these resources. So you need physical human resources and financial resources to operate a library. But majority of the institutions, I'm not talking about exceptional very few institutions, majority of the institutions had financial issues or the human resource issues or the infrastructural issues. So one or the other they all had, and which resulted in accessing many of the faculty members and the students were not able to access the knowledge resources, quality knowledge resources. So that is when the government of India thought they wanted to give equal access to knowledge resources to every Indian citizen. So that is when the National Digital Library of India came into existence. And today, the National Digital Library of India consists of contents from over 340 content contributors. So these content contributors range from research institutions, academic institutions, school educations, education boards, private digitized contents, multimedia contents. So we have over 340 content contributors who are part of the NDLI. What type of content we have? So we have computer science, information and general works content is about 1.36 crore resources. Philosophy and psychology, we have 5.8 lakh resources. Religion, we have 2.2 lakh resources. Social sciences, we have 52 lakh resources. Language, 1.8 lakh resources. Natural sciences and mathematics, we have 96 lakh resources. Technology, we have 1.2 crore resources. The arts, fine and decorative arts is about 10 lakh resources. Literature and rhetoric is about 9.6 lakh resources. History and geography is about another 9.4 lakh resources. So if you add all these resources, as of today, we have 5.89 crore resources. And out of these 5.89 crore resources, they are available in multiple access options. Two of the access options, the open and the NDLI users content, these green colored icons, these two give you full text access. Full text means you can download the entire book or article or video lecture or audio lecture and use it for educational purposes at free of cost. You don't have to pay a single penny for using these resources. And these 5.89 crore resources are available in multiple learning resource formats. What are these learning resource formats? It could be a faculty publication, a thesis, dissertation, ebooks, like PowerPoint presentations, video lectures, audio lectures, animations, coursewares, term papers, assignments, assessments, projects, lab experiments, question banks, annual reports, project reports, law acts, data sets, manuscripts, maps. So we have 60 different types of learning resource types available at NDLI. And who is this for? So initially when it started primarily for the higher educational institution, but soon we realized the resources have to be for every citizen. So now NDLA has content for school going children, college going youths, working professionals, academicians, researchers, entrepreneurs and lifelong learners. So anyone who is interested in learning, NDLA has content for them. Now we will see how to access these NDLA resources. So there are two ways through which you can access the National Digital Library of India. One is you can go to, if you are using a mobile phone, if you are using an Android phone, go to the Google Play Store and download the National Digital Library of India app. Or if you are using an iPhone, go to the App Store and then download the National Digital Library of app in your mobile phone. Okay. And then you can use the mobile app to search for resources. Or you can go to the mobile browser or desktop laptop computer or desktop machine and then open the browser and then search for the National Digital Library of India. So here I used Google search engine and then I searched for this topic. The first URL which you get, which is ndl.iitkgp.ac.in, this is our official URL. Okay, so you just have to click. Once you click, it will take you to our homepage. And this is how the new homepage of the National Digital Library of India looks like. So here you can see there is a browse button through which you can actually browse the content based on learning resource type, by source, by subject category. So you can actually browse. This is for search, right? So you can just enter the search keyword and search. And this language tab, this is primarily to change the interface of this NDLI portal. Suppose if you want to change the entire interface into your own mother tongue, suppose if you want it in Malayalam, just click on the language and go to you can see various Indian languages written here. You just choose Malayalam, then the entire interface will change into Malayalam. And this is the login button. So since I have already logged in, it is displaying my name. Otherwise, it will be showing login. Okay. Now, this is the search box. So here, you can enter the search keyword. Suppose if you want to, if you are finding a topic like, Newton's third law. So you just enter Newton's third law and click search. Then it will start displaying the results. And this is the newly created three sections. So this is the study at home section, wherein our team has actually classified the resources into various educational level and educational domain. So here you can see school content for school children. We also have CBSE examination preparatory materials, engineering subjects, science subjects, humanities, literature, law and management. Okay, and then we also have COVID-19 research repository, which consists of various resources under the COVID-19 on the topic of COVID-19, and also we have some featured collections. Say for example, we have a birth centenary of Satyajit Ray's materials. We also have Roald Dahl, topic of the week, talks and webinars. So you can see this is something very dynamic. Now I will show you how to search. Suppose if you want to search, what you need to do is just go to the search box and enter the search topic. The first topic I searched was on science project. Okay, because many of the children find it very difficult for especially to do a project. Okay, and so I searched for a topic called science project, and I wanted it specifically for 5th to 8th standard. So what I did, I searched for this topic and then I went to educational level. And I chose 5th to 8th standard. I got 910 science projects. Okay. And then I searched for a topic called poems. And I wanted specifically relevant poems for class 1 to 4. Okay. So I just chose 1 to 4. I went to education level and I chose 1 to 4. I got 372 poems for the children of class 1 to 4. And then I searched for a topic called algebra and calculus. Okay. this time I wanted the content only from Khan Academy. Some of you may know Khan Academy is one of those very useful and relevant video lectures on various educational topics, especially for the school children. So you click on source and then choose Khan Academy. You just have to enter Khan Academy and choose Khan Academy, then you will get the content only from Khan Academy. Okay. And the next topic I searched was on force and motion. Right? But I want only animated materials. Okay. So I just chose school subject and then I chose animated materials. I searched for class 12 force and motion. So here you can see, if I click here, I can see the video on experimental demonstration of static, kinetic and rolling friction. Okay. Similarly, you can see the other topics. You can just navigate through that. And then I searched for a topic called theory of relativity. Okay. So, and then I wanted specifically from a source called NPTEL. NPTEL stands for National Program on Technology Enabled Learning. So you just choose the content from NPTEL. You have got 51 video lectures on theory of relativity. And then I searched for IIT JEE preparatory materials. Okay. So what I did, I went to browse and I chose featured sources and I choose from NDLI tutor JEE main. I got 3312 materials, resources or solved papers. These are all NDLI tutors. So there are about 3312 solved questions for the children preparing for JEE main examination. Similarly, we have content for JEE advanced as well. And then I searched for a topic called artificial intelligence. And we also have resources for teachers also. Okay. So the teachers also can learn new topics and also they can use this platform to prepare educational materials or educational aids. So I searched for a topic called micro teaching. Now I'm going to show you what type of content we have under the school and CBSE examination preparatory materials. So how to access this? So this is available only in the desktop application, not in the mobile app, because the mobile app is getting revamped. So soon, once it is revamped, you will be able to see this newly created section. But currently, this you can see it only in the desktop application, or you can go to the browser and search for it. So suppose if I want to see what type of content available for school children, just click on the school. Then you can see the various subsections available under the school content. So we have video lectures available on various topics for children. We also have JEE preparation materials. We have simulations, activities, self-assessment and various other study materials. We also have books from CBSE, NCERT under the state boards also. I will show what type of content we have under the CBSE, NCERT in a little while. And also we have some books for general reading. So especially we have content from the National Book Trust and other partners also. And we have CBSE examination preparatory materials, especially for class 10th and 12th. Suppose if you want to understand by subject, just click on subject. Here you can see the various 10th subjects. So you can choose the topic of your choice, subject of your choice and start reading. And similarly for class 12, we have a lot of resources, various subjects are available. So what are some of the featured contents for school children? We have NCERT books, we have NBT books. We have Andhra Pradesh State Board, Gujarat, Jammu and Kashmir, Kerala, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Odisha, Punjab, Rajasthan, Tamil Nadu, Telangana and Tripura. So all these state board books are available at NDLI. How to access it? Just go to the source button and then you can choose the, or you can browse by a subject or source. Then you can get the relevant board also. Apart from this, we have some other not-for-profit as well as private player contents available. We have exam fear materials of class 6 to 12 school content. And also we have NEET preparation materials and English grammar from exam fear. We have Exploratorium, which is a scientific funhouse and experimental laboratory for school children. We also have resources from TED, like TEDx. We have resources from TED. TED has animated videos and lectures on ideas that spark teachers and students. We have resources from Khan Academy. We have computer science programming language video lectures from Spoken Tutorial. And we have resources from the National Science Digital Library, which has online educational resources for students and teachers on STEM, which is science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. We have the physics classroom. We have the NDLA tutor. We have the STEMS. We have the PET simulations. We also have Pratham Story Weaver. We have Teacher Tube, School in School, Science in School, teaching engineering STEM curriculum for K-12. So these are some of the featured sources available for school children. Now I'm going to show you how to download a resource from NDLI. Okay. So far we have seen what type of content, why NDLI was created, how to access it, what type of content we have. Now I'm going to show you how to view or download a resource from NDLI. Okay, so before I say that, I just wanted to tell you, for browsing and searching, you don't have to be registered or logged into NDLI, right? But if you want to view or download a content, then you must be registered and logged into NDLI, then only you will be able to do this. I think since you, many of the students are already registered from your school, I think most of you may be having the username and password from National Digital Library of India. In case if you don't have it, kindly contact your librarian, Ms. Priyadashni. She will be able to help you. So I searched for a topic called research methodology, and I wanted it specifically from Lovely Professional University. I got 1,438 resources. Now I want to download this resource. So what I have to do is just click on this resource, and it will take me to this page. So this is called the metadata. So here you can see there are two tabs, content and metadata. First click on the metadata. So this is the metadata section, which means the basic information about a resource, right? So now if you want to download this resource, the second thing you need to notice is whether this is a open access or NDLI access. Since it's open access, which means you can download this entire book, right? And the third thing and the last thing you need to notice is whether you have logged in or not. So here, since it's displaying my name, it means I've already logged into the NDLI portal. Now I can download this resource. So how to download? Just go to this here and then click content. And the entire 338 pages of content will get downloaded into your laptop or desktop or mobile phone or tablet, depending on whichever device you are using. And in case if you have not logged into NDLI, right? So in that case, once you click on the content, it will take you to this page. It will ask you to please log in to view this content. So what you need to do is just click on this login button, and this pop-up window will open. Okay. If you are an already registered member, and if you remember your registered email ID and password, just enter the registered email ID and password, enter the CAPTCHA, and click login. Once you click login, it will automatically get downloaded. Okay. In case you registered at NDLI a couple of months back, and you didn't get the verification email, or you registered and you forgot your password, in that case what you can do is just click on this account recovery button, then this pop-up window will appear, right? Here you just enter the registered email ID and click submit, then you will get an automated email to reset your password. Just follow the process and reset your password. And in case this is the first time you're hearing about NDLI and you never registered, then you just click on the register button, then this registration form will open. Just fill the basic information about yourself and sign up, then you will get an account activation verification email. Just click on the URL, then your account will get activated. So this is how you have to be using NDLI. In case if it's a video lecture, this is how the video lecture will play within the frame, right? So For using NDLI, you need to remember two important things. One is, you should know the correct search keyword. That's the first one. And the second thing you need to know is, you should know the various filter options through which you can narrow down the search results, right? Say, for example, I'm going to talk about some 8 important filter options which will help you in narrow downing your results. The first filter option is access restriction, right? So this will help you in, suppose if you want only full text resources, you searched on a topic called artificial intelligence and you wanted to read only the full text resources. You don't want to only read the metadata, but you wanted the entire content to be read. So in that case, what you need to do is just choose open and NDLI, then you will get only the open source and full text resources, right? And then you can choose content by author, subject category, file format, language. So at NDLI, the contents are available in at least 300 languages, both Indian as well as international languages, right? And you can choose the language of your choice. Suppose if you search for a topic on, say what you call theory of relativity, and you wanted this in Malayalam, so what you can do is just go here and type Malayalam. If the content is available in Malayalam, then it will display just choose Malayalam, then you will get the content only in Malayalam, right? And then learning resource type, I earlier told you there are more than 60 different types of learning resource type available. You can choose the learning resource type of your choice. And then source. So earlier I told you there are 340 content contributors available at NDLI. So all these content contributors are listed under the source category or source filter. So you can just choose the content from the relevant source. And the 8th filter option, which is available only in the desktop application, is called content type. So here you can see text, presentation, audio, video. Suppose if you want only video lectures, just choose video. Okay. I earlier told you, you can actually change the Indian language interface into various Indian languages. So how you do is, just click on the language button, then choose the language of your choice. Currently, it's available in Hindi, Bangla, Gujarati, Kannada, Marathi, Assamese, Tamil, Uriya, Malayalam, and Punjabi is also underway, and other Indian languages are also, our team is working on. Okay, so far we have seen how to use the desktop application. Now I'm going to show you how to use the NDLI mobile app. Okay. So earlier I told you, if you are using an Android phone, go to the Google Play Store, or if you are using an iPhone, go to the App Store and search for the National Digital Library of India. So you have to enter the entire name. Okay, then only the app will display. So here you can see the logo, which is NDLI, the app name and the publisher name. All the three should be National Digital Library of India. Then only you have to click install. Okay, once you install, if you want to open the app, just click on the app. So this first screen, this is how the home screen of the National Digital Library of India looks like. Okay, here you can see the subject domain wise content, learning resource type wise content. We also have some featured sources. Now I want to search on a topic called Uttar Pradesh. So what I have to do is just click on the search icon, then the search box will appear. Just enter the search keyword and then click search from the keypad, right? Now I got 41,573 results. Okay, now I wanted to the content only from Aligarh Muslim University. Okay, so what I have to do is apply filters. So what I did, just clicked on this orange color icon. This is the filter icon here. Just click here, then you can see various filter options visible here. Now I went to a filter called source and I wanted the content only from Aligarh Muslim University and then clicked apply. I got 199 results from on this topic of Uttar Pradesh from Aligarh Muslim University. So this is how we have to use the NDLI mobile app. So I'm going to give you a small activity after this webinar is over. I want each one of you to download and install NDLI mobile app in your mobile phone and then search for the topic of your choice. And let me know whether it is useful for you or not. Okay, now we have come to the last part of the presentation, which is second last part of the presentation, which is Google versus NDLI. How is it different from each other? So we will see it with the help of an example. So imagine there is a girl called Payal who is studying in class 8 and her native language is Hindi. And she wants to, or she's very scared of magnetism in the subject of physics. Okay. Similarly, there is a guy called Shamik who wants to pursue his PhD on this topic of magnetism. Now, both of them went to Google and they searched for the same topic, magnetism, and they got 1.89 crore results. And then they came to NDLI and they searched for the same topic called magnetism and they got 11,16,000 results. Okay. Now, what Payal did was, she applied two filters. The first filter she applied was educational level, she chose 5th to 8th standard. And the language filter, she chose Hindi. She got only 8 results. Similarly, what Shamik did was, he just chose career and technical papers. So, and he got 219 results. So, imagine where is 8 and 219 results and where is 1.89 crore results. So, from this example, we can understand what is the difference between Google and NDLI. So before I get into this, I wanted to tell you how Google functions. So the moment you put a search term called magnetism, what Google does is it goes around the entire world wide web, and wherever this term called magnetism is there, search keyword called magnetism is there, it will pull the results and display it in front of you. So that's a brilliant task, right? So nobody can do this work. I think Google is, or any search engine is doing that work brilliantly, but it has its own cons. What are these cons? First and foremost, Google can't distinguish whether it is coming from an authorized, authentic or an unauthentic source. Okay, because in the internet, you can see you can have both authentic information as well as unauthentic source also. So Google can't distinguish whether it's coming from an authentic source or an unauthentic source. Second one is, it can't distinguish whether it is real information or fake information. It can't validate. Okay? And the third is, whether it can't distinguish whether it's an educational content or non-educational content. So when you search, it will pull both educational and non-educational content as well, right? And the last one is, it doesn't know whether it is relevant for Shamik or Payal or Vignesh. It can't distinguish. Okay, it will pull the results and display it in front of you. And it's up to the user to narrow down the results, right? But on the other hand, each content that is available at NDLI is curated educational content only. We don't have any non-educational materials. We have only educational content in our portal. So that is the first and major difference between Google and NDLI. And the second difference is, you can actually narrow down the results using the educational filter options. In Google also, you have advanced search option, but they are all very generic in nature. But our filter options are very specific to the educational field. Third one is, you can modify the search based on content type. And the fourth one is, the government of India has procured national licensing from a couple of publishers and given it to the NDLI registered users at free of cost, which Google doesn't. So these are the major difference between Google and NDLI. So now we have come to the last part of the presentation, which is how to set up and operate a NDLI club in your own institution. So the primary objective of starting this NDLI club is to promote the culture of reading. So that's the primary objective. Now, how to do this? Since your institution has already set up an NDLI club, so you have to be a member of a group of committed people, has to be a member of this club, and you have to ensure that all the students and faculty members are registered under the NDLI and they start using. You have to give them an awareness also. Registration is the first step, but it doesn't stop there. That's just a beginning. You have to ensure that each of them, each of the students and faculty members feel comfortable in using the app as well as the website, so that they start using NDLI. So ensure that everybody is registered. Now, this next part is, you have to conduct at least 10 reading related activities. So some of the institutions have conducted 50-60 activities in a year, but we encourage at least 10 reading related activities to be conducted within the 1 year of issuing the certificate. So what type of activities you can conduct? It could be a lecture series or a quiz competition or a storytelling session or a go fish session, film screening, drawing competition, role play, writing competition, maker space or debate. Or you can also come up with your own reading or knowledge related activities and intercollege activities or competition as well. And this has to be uploaded on the NDLA form, NDLA club activity form. We will verify at the end of the year to issue the renew your certificate of registration. These are some of the activities being conducted by various NDLA clubs across the country. And that's it from my end. If you have any questions, I would be happy to respond to your questions. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for that enlightening session. As we've come to know, the NDLA is home to a vast collection of resources on numerous topics, all of which is a click away. With this orientation from you, I'm sure that we'll be able to utilize them to the fullest. To draw the event to a close, I invite Aparna Nair to propose a vote of thanks.
Respected chief guest of the day, Dr. Vignesh Swarnamohan, principal, vice principal, teachers, and all other members of the NDLI club. Namaste and a warm good afternoon to one and all present here. I deem it my privilege to propose the vote of thanks on behalf of the entire fraternity of Bhavans Vidya Mandir Erur. At the very outset, I extend my heartfelt gratitude to Dr. Vignesh Swarnamohan, Chief Strategic Outreach Officer, NDLI, for being with us and enlightening us with the true potential of the National Digital Library and the ways and means to utilize the resources in the most effective manner. Thank you, sir. I would like to thank our principal, Parvati ma'am, and vice principal, Ramya ma'am, for leading and supporting us in all our endeavors, and also for arranging this wonderful orientation program. Let me also thank the members of the NDLI club for their enormous cooperation. Once again, thank you all for making this program a fruitful one. Thank you.
Thank you everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you once again, everyone, and I wish you all a great evening. Thank you.